So to debug problems in App Inventor, I have kind of four methods that I use. The first is to change properties while I'm testing, so changing properties of components. Adding labels to display values as the app is running. Notifier alerts to also display information within the app. And then the do it block. And I'm going to go over all four of those.
There are a few different ways that you can debug your apps. The first way is just simply as you're in live testing, you can change values in your, say, properties. So I've got this ocean plastic cleanup, and I've got my diver and my fish moving across the screen. And say I'm a little confused about how the heading property works. So what I can do is, say, click on the diver and say change his heading to 90 and see what happens. And I see, oh, he's going straight up. So I've now learned that 90 makes the diver go straight up. And I could say, okay, let's put him back to zero. And then he's going to the right. So I could check, oh, what does that mean then for 45? So that makes it go up and to the right. Playing with properties while you're doing live testing can certainly help you debug a situation and figure out how things work. If I want to go further and say, oh, you know, I really want to kind of track what the heading is as he's moving. So what I've got is these two buttons up and down, and I've got it controlling it by actually changing it in code. But say I want to be a little more clear on exactly what my heading situation is, what I can do is go back to my designer and say, I'm just going to throw in another label here, and I'm just going to put it up here next to what I've got for my health, and because this is just going to be temporary and just for debugging. And what I can do is go to my blocks, and as you can see here, I've got the up button adds 5 to the heading, and the down button subtracts 5. So what I can do is set the label's text to be the value that I'm looking for. So in this case, say I want to know what the diver's heading is at any point. And so I can just set that and say I want to do that in both cases when I hit the up or the down button. And so if I do that, now I'm hitting up and the value's going up, and I'm hitting down and the value's going down. So I can track that as I need it. This is just an example, but it's really helpful to use labels to display the value of something that you're looking for. And then when you're done with it, you can go ahead and just go and click on the component, the label, and then just delete it. And then the code will be gone and the component itself will be gone. And this is all after you've debugged it and figured out what you need to know. So those are two different ways, using properties and changing them as you go, and then also adding a label to your app somewhere and displaying the value that you're trying to track. Here is another example where we can use a different method of debugging. This is the login app where the user can register and then type in their username and password to enter an app. So the way this works is a user can come in and try to enter, and if the user's not found, it will ask the user to register by entering the password a second time. And then it takes them to, in this case, a second screen. If we look at the blocks behind it, we've got a submit button that first checks if the username and password have been entered, and then it calls CloudDB to get the value of that user from the username text box. Then CloudDB returns the value, and then it basically checks that the username matches the tag and the password matches the value. So in CloudDB, the username will be the tag and the value will be the password. So say for some reason I, you know, am testing this with my student and I think I know the password, and it keeps giving me incorrect passwords. So this is just another example, but what I can do is use the notifier. So back in the designer, it's under the user interface notifier. I've actually already included one in here for other messaging in my app, but what I can do is back in the blocks, click on notifier, and the easiest one is to use the show alert. So say every time I get information back from CloudDB in the got value, I actually want to know what the tag and its value are. So what I can do is I can actually display that information for myself. So I can do join and say I'm going to add another string, and what I will do is display the tag and the value. And I'm just going to separate that with a comma to make life easier. What's going to happen is now if I hit submit over here, so it went out to CloudDB and returned student with the correct password, which was 123456. So me as a tester now can say, oh, I actually forgot my password, and I should be able to get into it. So it should match it, and it should then let me in. It takes me to screen 2 in that case. So again, notifier show alert is a nice easy way to display information kind of on the fly. After I've debugged it, you just drag the block out and you can get rid of it. The last strategy for debugging is the do it command. So as long as you are connected to the companion, whether it be the emulator or on your phone, you can use this do it. So for instance, say I'm using CloudDB and for some reason I want to clear a tag. So I just added myself as student and say I want to then go back and erase that from CloudDB. So what I can do is get the block that will do that, and if I right click, there's this do it command. So if I do it, that will actually execute that piece of code. And then if I try to go back, and I just added, and I should be able to get in, but it's going to say new user because I've just deleted it. So this is a way to manipulate either values in your code, and in this case CloudDB, using do it. So I had to go back in and add that again. Let's think of another way that we might use this. Oh, another way that we could use it would be if I wanted to add something in there without actually, you know, having to go through it in code. So I could say something like, yeah, so say I want to add a user. So that would add a username of JoJo with the value testing. So if I go ahead and select do it, that should put that user in there. So now if I were to able to go in here, I could type in JoJo and testing. And it accepted it. So I can go back to screen 1 again. So these are simple examples, but you can do this with anything. If I wanted to, you know, if you wanted to even test a particular piece of code, so for instance here, so if I just say do it, it will run that piece of code. If I just want to do it to test that this particular piece of code works, you can do it. So the do it is really cool to, you know, try one piece of code, a block that you're not sure if it's working correctly, go ahead and use that do it. So once again, we've got 4 different methods for debugging. We've got, you know, changing properties on the fly with the live testing, adding labels to display values, using the notifier to display information or values of components or variables, and then lastly, this do it to actually run additional code within your app. Hopefully, with all these different methods, you'll be able to figure out any errors you have in your app so it works beautifully.